It is almost too ridiculous to mention it, but I'm afraid I have to, because of the more than 40% of the American population who, as I lamented in chapter one, accept the Bible literally. Think what the geographical distribution of animals should look like if they'd all dispersed from Noah's Ark. Shouldn't there be some sort of law of decreasing species diversity as we move away from an epicenter, perhaps Mount Ararat? I don't need to tell you that is not what we see. Why would all those marsupials, ranging from tiny pouched mice through koalas and bilbies to giant kangaroos and diprotodonts, why would all those marsupials, but no placentals at all, have migrated en masse from Mount Ararat to Australia? Which route did they take? And why did not a single member of their straggling caravan pause on the way and settle in India, perhaps, or China, or some haven along the Great Silk Road? Why did the entire order Edentata, all 20 species of armadillo, including the extinct giant armadillo, all 6 species of sloth, including extinct giant sloths, and all 4 species of anteater, troop off unerringly for South America? Leaving not a rack behind, leaving no hide nor hair nor armor plate of settlers somewhere along the way. Why did all the penguins undertake the long waddle south to the Antarctic, not a single one to the equally hospitable Arctic? Once again, I'm sorry to take a sledgehammer to so small and fragile a nut, but I have to do so. I have to do so because more than 40% of the American people believe literally in the story of Noah's Ark. We should be able to ignore them and get on with our science, but we can't afford to because they control school boards. They homeschool their children to deprive them of access to proper science teachers. And they include many members of the United States Congress, some state governors, and even presidential and vice presidential candidates. They have the money and the power to build institutions, universities, even a museum, where children ride life-size mechanical models of dinosaurs with saddles, which they're solemnly told coexisted with humans. We can't afford to be snooty in Britain about that. 28% of the British population get their science from the Flintstones as well, believing that humans coexisted with dinosaurs.